night, and the Ron Carter Trio is playing at Keystone Corner in Baltimore. This new jazz club in the city's Harbor East neighborhood opened less than a year ago and gets world-class acts.
We opened with Ron Carter, who is the most famous living bass player of our time. And he's an old friend and a good friend, and who played the original Keystone Corner in San Francisco many, many times. So it was really a full circle kind of experience.
Co-owner and jazz impresario Todd Barkin opened the first Keystone Corner in 1972 in San Francisco. Recreating it in Baltimore is a win.
It was something that, you know, was always near and dear to my heart. I'm a club owner at heart.
This club represents the momentum happening with jazz in the city right now. At a cafe table at Mount Vernon Marketplace, Baltimore Jazz Alliance board members are planning events in the city, like the Baltimore Jazz Festival that was first held last summer, and another jazz conference. The Alliance has been around since 2003. Their quarterly newsletter keeps artists and audiences abreast of what's going on.
It really seems to be having a renaissance. There's a lot of new activity, a lot of great players, and new festivals, just new stuff coming up all the time.
This statue of Billie Holiday on Pennsylvania and West Lafayette is a reminder of jazz's heyday in Baltimore, when greats like her and Cab Calloway, who are both from Baltimore, would play local clubs. The Charles Theater was once the famous ballroom, and for more than 40 years, the Left Bank Jazz Society helped bring in other big names like Count Basie, Duke Ellington, and John Coltrane. But times have changed. Popular music these days is much different, and enthusiasts say much of the change is because of how we listen to music.
People are doing more, you know, streaming, and you know, you're playing, you have a lot of DJs. Once the DJs came out, that cut down the venues for live performers. But the thing with jazz has always been best performed live.
We are so sensorially bombarded by so much stuff that it's harder for the highest quality things to kind of get through and be understood and be appreciated.
But it's appreciated at venues like Germano's in Little Italy, where local bands like Mike and Ike often take the stage. The golden era of jazz is gone, but with local events and the big names who come to town, jazz is reemerging in Charm City in a new way. Theo Hayes, WBAL-TV 11 News.